What's up guys, it's Shuichi here. This week, why don't we talk about the subject of crutch perks, shall we? Just a quick explanation, crutch perks are perks that are bought almost every game by the collective community without fail. The most notable of these crutch perks would be Juggernog, hence why I did not include it in the best perk list, because everybody gets it, so it'd be pointless when it's obvious that it's the best perk. This video is going to be centered around the instability of crutch perks throughout the games, starting from World at War and ending with Cold War. Just a quick note before you start watching the video, this video is not backed by stats. This video is backed by just watching the collective community over the years. Quick disclaimer, if you're looking for a stat YouTuber, I am not that guy. I do not look that deep into zombies. I am more just one for fun and observation. Anyways, shall we begin? Perks were first introduced in World at War on Zombies Varrock. Its predecessor did not have any perks on it because it was the fruit of experimentation within Call of Duty. Within Zombies Varrock, we got our taste of four fresh perks. Jug, Quick Revive, Double Tap, and Speed Cola. Of course, being new and all, you couldn't really call them crutch perks because they were the only four perks to begin with. And of course, you'd be buying all four unless you were playing single player, in which case you would ignore buying Quick Revive because Quick Revive did not revive you back then. It goes without saying, these four perks went a while without being challenged, until Black Ops' Ascension brought in two new perks that would change the meta. Here, we were introduced to PhD Flopper and Stamina. PhD Flopper was new and it was exciting because it was something different. Once it came out, you would see everybody getting that perk because it was something to try and it was exhilarating. Despite not having the same type of excitement as PhD, Stamina Up still brought something new to the table as well that was really useful. You could more easily traverse the map. With these two introduced, perks like Double Tap found itself challenged for the 4 perk position. Jug and Speed still managed to maintain their position as the top 4 perks. That was not going away. But now you saw Quick Revive and Double Tap being switched out. We were finally moving away from having just the same 4 perks every time. The only time you wouldn't really see this change would be single player, because people still needed Quick Revive. As we went through Black Ops 1, we saw another perk introduced on Call of the Dead. Sadly, this perk did not leave much for game-changing gameplay, so it still did not challenge the remaining two spots. Well, it didn't challenge any of the four, if we're being honest. Deadshot Dagger, you will not be missed. I know you're not gone, but you will not be missed. Except Cold War, because you actually did something there. But we're not talking about Cold War yet, so you're gonna have to sit on the back burner. With the final DLC of Black Ops, we are introduced to one more perk, Mule Kick. And the thing about this perk is it was put on every single Black Ops map. This perk was a headache to navigate at first, but it became more useful as you went on, especially when Black Ops just wouldn't drop you max ammo in the later rounds. At the end of Black Ops, we had 8 new perks. With all these being introduced, there was no way that the main 4 perks would not be challenged at this point. We'd finally reached a point where crutch perks were becoming less and less. Jug would always be the crutch perk that's not being changed, that's a given. But it didn't matter because now we had 7 perks for the other 3 spots. So you don't want to heal and you want to run and gun? You can opt for perks that set you that way. You want to be the team's healer? There's perks for that. We'd finally reached that point, and things were great. Up until Black Ops 2 hit. With the introduction of Transit, Deadshot, Mule Kick, and everybody's favorite, PhD, were removed from selection. To satisfy everybody's perk cravings, they tried to add a new perk to selection, Tombstone Soda, but this perk held no value to the players whatsoever. On top of that, they did us a favor by changing Double Tap to make it better. This only worsened the whole crutch perk thing because now we were back to using the main 4 perks. And maybe Stamina Up with one of the 4 perks interchangeable. Further DLC only worsened the divide. Die Rise, while introducing another perk, took away the perk it had just introduced on Transit. On top of that, PhD was still unobtainable and they took out Stamina Up to put in Mule Kick. At least with Mob of the Dead we got a break by getting a new good perk, but they still made PhD and Mule Kick unobtainable. Matter of fact, we were actually down to 5 perks at this point. With Deadshot being as bad as it is, we were down to 4 perks that were viable on Mob of the Dead. We ended up back at square one. Thankfully, the last two maps saved us from that. The last two DLCs introduced Buried, which brought in a new perk and had 7 perks total on the map, and Origins, which had introduced the Wonderfizz machine. This machine could get you any of the perks that were previously introduced. Okay, correction. Wonderfist could only get you 7 of the 8 perks from Black Ops 1, excluding Quicker Vibe, and it could get you Electric Cherry from Black Ops 2. Despite this, this is still a whole lot of change that we needed. Black Ops 3 made sure to keep this a happy medium by maintaining the Wonderfist machine, and it introduced one of everybody's favorite perks, Widow's Wine. Personally, I'm not a fan of this perk, but I see why people love it. Widow's Wine kind of became a crutch perk in its own, but I wouldn't say it was that bad. With the Wonderfist machine now introduced, we had a wide selection on each map. It didn't change the fact that Jug remained the crutch perk, and we had Widow's Wine. And sometimes people would stick with Speed Cola. But we had managed to stray from where we had started once again, and it was great. I'd say the only downside was they never really introduced another perk after that in Black Ops 3, but it didn't matter because we had variety. And this variety was maintained throughout the whole game. Then Black Ops 4 hit. The directors thought crutch perks were a problem. And by crutch perks, they just meant Jug. They took away our Jug. And you know, I was mad about that. I really was. But then I realized, with the 4-hit system, it wasn't as bad as I thought it was gonna be. Of course, we didn't start out with that 4-hit system because they offered us 3 hits in the beginning. 3 hits! Why would you take away Jug and only offer us 3 hits? But after some reflection, the 4-hit system wasn't that bad because from World at War to Black Ops 2, we only got 2 hits in the beginning. Those 4 hits were consistent, and we had them the whole game. But them taking away Jug wasn't the problem here. They attempted to remove crutch perks by adding 17 new perks to our selection. I say new, some of them aren't new, but you get the point. And even though they introduced 17 new perks, you could only go into a match with 4 perks at a time. That's right, 4 perks. Weren't you supposed to be able to, like, vary everything? But you can't vary anything during a match if you only have the 4 perks that spawn in. Not only that, but I can almost guarantee you if you sent me a picture of your perk selection right now, they're gonna be the same as almost everybody else. It's probably gonna be something like Winner's Will in the modifier spot, Dying Wish, Quick Revive, and possibly Stamina. But I'm gonna be honest, I always run Dying Wish in my modifier spot, so I'm kinda being a hypocrite here. Let's be honest looking over this perk selection they gave us. Who's gonna run Victorious Tortoise? Who's gonna run Bandolier Bandit? Who's gonna run Death Perception? I guarantee you almost none of you. But I need to calm down because I'm sure you guys get the point by now. Crutch perks were a huge problem in Black Ops 4. There was no reason to take away the perk selection we had. And now we were stuck with something shitty. If I wanted to switch my perks up mid-game, I was no longer able to do that. It kind of ruined the experience, if I'm gonna be honest. But we should probably move on from that. Cause now I wanna have some grief at Cold War. They did us a favor by bringing back all the perks we've come to love. They hurt us. But I wasn't satisfied because now you could buy all of them. It kind of ruined the experience of having limitations. It's kind of funny though, because once you think about it, you can't have crutch perks if you can buy all the perks. I mean, it's great logic, but it's very flawed. With Cold War, we no longer had crutch perks. We could buy them all, so there was no need for that. And it's kind of sad, but my problem with Cold War's perk system actually trails off into the fact you can upgrade it. They try to do us a favor by making the perks upgradable, something to work towards, but I just didn't like the fact you could make the game really easy by upgrading these things. It felt like cheating in a sense. Not to mention the fact that the game's already easy as is. Cold War is the easiest Call of Duty there is out there. It's why it's gonna be my least favorite of them all, because the Easter eggs just felt soulless. Snap out of it. Snap out of it, because this isn't about Cold War, it's about crutch perks. So at this point, I guess it's time for a recap. World at War introduced the 4-perk system with 4 perks that could not be broken. Then came along Black Ops, where Black Ops introduced 4 new perks, and that changed the meta entirely. Black Ops 2 kind of ruined that by taking perks in and out, and it made it inconsistent until finally Origins came along with Wonderfizz. Black Ops 3 kept that happy medium and introduced a new perk at the same time. And then that's when the devs decided that they weren't happy with crutch perks that weren't really a problem at that point, and they decided to take out all the perks we've come to love. And instead, they replaced it with around 13 perks that we would not use ever. The other 4 ended up being crutch perks that became a bigger problem than we've ever seen. And then finally, they gave us our perks back in Cold War. and their solution to the crutch perk problem? Make them all buyable. Why not? I'm sure you guys are probably tired of hearing me rant by now, so I think it's time for us to wrap up this video. If there are any videos you want to see in the future, make sure to list them down in the comments, and make sure to like and subscribe because it really helps me out and I am trying to grow. I eventually want to make it big, you know? If there's any constructive criticism you have, make sure to leave it in the comments, because you guys did that with the forbidden doors and it really did help in my opinion. Once again, thank you all again for watching, and don't die.